alcohol has just been banned.
In 1920, the U.S. government actually passed a constitutional law outlawing the production and distribution of alcohol. Or did it? During this so-called dry age, a lot of people saw this ban on alcohol as an excuse to get even more creative with their homemade liquors and flavors. And underground crime organizations saw a chance to slide into a very profitable market. They started creating speakeasies or underground jazz and dance halls where liquor was plentiful. In fact, speakeasies were all the rage. It is estimated that at one point in New York City, there were 32,000 speakeasies alone. So within these illicit social networks came a lot of new freedoms, specifically for women. Enter the flapper. You've probably seen her in movies and pictures. For the first time ever in this decade, women started chopping off their huge Victorian hair, getting rid of their Victorian corsets, and going for risque knee-length dress and even trousers. As women started drinking their illegal substance, a cocktail ring was a way to show off through a flashy, beautiful way this freedom and utter inhibition. This era of creativity, though sometimes dangerous, led to some of the most famous concoctions, maybe 70% of the cocktails we see on a typical cocktail menu. Stay tuned to part 4 to figure out what happens when the US government goes back on their word.